On November the 10th, 2023, in the concert hall of the National Center for Performing Arts, a ripple of applause rose. With the flashes of magnesium light, the China National Symphony Orchestra and the Philadelphia Orchestra on the 13th tour to China exchanged the gifts. The friendly scene seemed to pull us back to 50 years ago.
72年尼克松来访华，推荐费城交响乐团来中国访问。我们作为国交，接待了他们。这一次呢，虽然是文化交流，但是也是中美建交的一个破冰之旅，所以这件事情的意义非同小可，应该说是一次世界性的合作。
In 1973, over 100 members of the Philadelphia Orchestra flew across the Pacific and set foot on the land of China, becoming the first American orchestra to visit China after the founding of New China. Friendship holds the key to sound state-to-state relations. Heart-to-heart communication contributes to deeper friendship. Across time, space, and national borders, this friendship bridge built of music has played a significant role in promoting the establishment of Sino-US diplomatic relations.
当时是七几年，我们的乐器都陈旧了，大管底下都烂掉了，都抠掉了再补一块木头，有的小号呢，都拿焊锡焊了，但是咱们有一个为中国人争光那么一个精神，卯足了劲给他们演奏，可以说折服了他们。所以呢，他们给我们的木管、小号、铜管，还有一些乐谱、唱片，那可以说是雪里送炭了。来而不往非礼者，咱们回送礼物，最珍贵的就是特制的给他定了这么一个大锣。
一看到我们台地的一个大锣，简直就是轰动了。这些队员们，他们没有见过这么大的锣。
Since the 18th century, when the gong was introduced to a Western symphony due to its special sound effect, in every symphony orchestra there must be one and only one Chinese instrument, gong. Singing can continue in a lack of strings, but music cannot be formed in a lack of gongs. Only the gong made in China has the most authentic sound. So this king of gongs, with a diameter of 1.1 meters, appears even more precious as a gift.
The gifts we received from the Central Philharmonic in 1973 were deeply meaningful to us. We keep them backstage. We see them nearly every day when we walk backstage, and it has a lasting quality.